Thank you. been his minister for 16 years. The senior minister at the church where he's been for 80 years. It's his church. And I felt blessed and honored to be his minister for this last chapter of his life. We have a saying in our denomination, no matter who you are or where you are in life's journey, you are welcome here. It's one thing to have a motto. It's another thing to really embody it. heart her. She said, Sarah, I'm almost 90, and I have thought about Mayflower all of these years. I've always wanted to write a thank you letter to that church. I encouraged her to do so, and I brought the letter back with me from Istanbul. And then, this last week, up to the cabin. Dear Mayflower Church, she writes, most of us have sometimes delayed writing thank you notes, but mine has been over 7 years and coming from very far away. I can easily close my eyes and retrace my steps. I lived at 55th and Wentworth Avenue. I would walk down to the corner of Wentworth and Diamond Lake Road, turn right past the old lumberyard on the left, cross Nicollet, and walk the remaining short distance to the place where I learned the most in all my life, Mayflower Church. I began in Sunday school when I was about 5 years old. And then she writes about Sunday school and choirs and youth group and all of the activities that shaped her as a child and youth and young adult. And then she writes, I would like to sit down to talk with the people to whom I owe so much. Silas Meckel, Catherine Brackett, and Russell Brackett, Russ's parents. Reverend Meckel combined the broad-mindedness and congregational ways along with an inclusion of ritual that I loved. The greatest influence of the church, she writes, was during my junior and high school years. Listen to this. She writes, the Bracketts organized things that in those days were not done by any other church or even school. We were taught about Judaism and taken as a group to a bar mitzvah and to meet with people afterwards. We went to services at two Catholic churches. We were driven a long ways into North Minneapolis, which was as remote to me as Africa, and there attended services at one of the few then black churches with wonderful choirs which swayed and danced as they sang. We went to church camp in the summer, and Catherine Brackett arranged for some of us to live with farm families for a month and to help out in the house and in the fields. She writes, I have so much gratitude and love. With wonderful parents like that,
Please turn now to bulletin.